Dear students, I'm happy to see that so many of you are interested to discover the beautiful world of transport phenomena. Transport phenomena deal with the transport of mass, energy and momentum. Think of the transport of liquids and gases through large pipelines, energy loss by conduction, or diffusion of milk in your coffee. All these processes occur at different scales. For example, you can lose energy through the window of your room, but also in industry, huge heat exchangers are used to heat or cool liquids and gases. Another example is diffusion. You can observe the diffusion of your milk in your coffee or tea, but on an industrial scale, it occurs in large extraction columns. The theory of transport phenomena is used for the design of many products and chemical plants where continuously mass and heat are transported. But also for fun, to estimate the boiling time of an egg or to establish how long your turkey should be in the oven. In the petrochemical industry, a question could be how to calculate heat and pressure loss. While in the microelectronic industry, an important issue could be what's the most cost-effective way of cooling chips? But also the reduction of the air resistance of cars or the oxygen transfer in water treatment plants could be tackled with transport phenomena. You have to realize that you have always a driving force, like a temperature difference, and as a result, transport of energy. The rate of transport depends on the resistance of the material and the geometry of the equipment. Think about the heat conduction in wood and copper through a tube wall or a flat plate, for instance. So in the last case, energy is transported from a higher temperature to a lower temperature in a certain object or volume. The question is, what is the geometry of the volume or object and in what direction is the heat transferred? For this reason, we always want to visualize the problem first by making a clear drawing to see what kind of processes are involved and look how we can solve the involved questions. The drawing can deal with a part of an apparatus or a single bubble in a bottle of champagne or a huge installation in an industrial environment. One of the first things is to look what is transported and what is the volume or geometry involved. For example, if you heat up a certain volume of water in a water cooker, the question could be how much energy costs this and how long does it take before the water reaches a temperature of 90 degrees Celsius? Or more complex, in an industrial unit where liquids and gases flow in and out and heat is lost to the surroundings. Let's look at the last example. We draw a sketch of an industrial vessel where liquids flow in and out. A general mass balance can now be written as the change of mass of the liquid in the vessel as a function of time is equal to the amount of the liquid entering the vessel minus the amount leaving the vessel. To model this phenomena, we translate it into a formula. If the inflow and outflow are different, we can calculate if the liquid in the vessel increases or decreases. For example, how long does it take before a beaker of coffee is filled? Let's assume that the flow rate is 15 milliliters per second. There's no outflow, so we have only an inflow of coffee until the beaker is full. This gives us a time of about 10 seconds to fill this mug. We have now seen an example of the mass balance, but in a similar way, we could set up an energy balance. This means that you have to look what changes in time and how much energy enters the volume and how much leaves the considered volume. Take the coffee in the mug. The coffee cools down, so how long can we drink this coffee? A balance and a few assumptions will give you the answer. The question, how to balance, is a matter of bookkeeping, just like the money in your wallet or the number of people entering and leaving a supermarket. In general, we can say, look how much is going into a well-defined volume and how much leaves this volume. If you have a steady state, this means that the same amount enters and leaves the volume and nothing changes in time. But if they are different, the mass or energy changes in the volume as a function of time. Make the exercises because the balance forms a keystone of this course. Thank you for your attention.